Southern Illinois' 2006 season started off with Lock Haven, and the Hogs were out to support the Dogs. And the 17th-ranked Salukis showed they were poised to go after their fourth straight Gateway Conference championship.
I mean, that was the first game that I'd played in a long time, you know, since high school. So, you know, I definitely wasn't as good as I could be, and, you know, I took off running a little bit too much.
Nick looked good. He was running all over the place. I think we're going to start calling him Nick Vic. That's his new name.
After a home opening win, the Salukis turned their attention to the University of Indiana. On this Saturday, Southern gave the Hoosiers all they can handle in a game that will be remembered for years to come.
SIU takes another step into the world of Division 1A football today, visiting Indiana for the first time ever. It's the first meeting ever between the Salukis and the Hoosiers. The Salukis playing a 1A opponent here this afternoon for the 22nd time ever. Now he comes in motion and they hand it to him, trying to sweep left, and that's an easy touchdown. And it's all Indiana early in this game. The Hoosiers lead it 6-0. Plenty of time to throw to the end zone. The pass is tipped incomplete, and Patrick Jordan's upset he didn't pick that pass off. Here is Lewis to throw to the three. It's tipped and caught, a touchdown. It went right through Brandon Jordan's hands. The Hoosiers go ahead 13-0. There's the snap. Play action, keeps it, runs off left end, break a tackle to the 35. First down, fumbled the ball at the 40-yard line. There's a scramble at the 41. Hill stretching for extra yards, gave the ball up. Lewis is in shotgun, there's the snap, rushes on, so he has time. Throwing the deep ball at the 5-yard line, it's caught and it is intercepted by Southern. Intercepted at the 2-yard line, the defense made the play. It's Craig Turner who had single coverage.
I didn't want anybody to make a big play on me, speaking that it's going to be on TV. I don't think nobody wants that. It just so happened the guy ran one of the plays that I was familiar with watching film, and I was able to, you know, gather myself and get up for the ball.
From the 5, middle of the field, play action, field to throw, setting up, throwing to the end zone for Jones, he got it, it's a touchdown! Braden Jones caught it. Hill threw a beauty.
The thing about that, Mike, is this really puts Southern back in this ballgame emotionally.
There's the snap. Handoff, thick pin, sweeping left. Blockers in front of him. It's an easy 6 for IU. And the Hoosiers move ahead 20-7. Plenty of time, setting to the end zone, wide open, touchdown SIU! On the back boundary for the score, it's Kearns, and it's his first touchdown.
How about some props for that offensive line that gave Hill all the time in the world to set up and find his receiver in the back of the end zone.
Here's Lewis to throw, and he's in trouble. He fumbled the ball. Southern's out at the 21-yard line. Micah King forced the fumble.
Lorenzo's recovered fumble after Micah King stripped it was, you know, another big change in the game. Turnovers are real big, and to get him against Indiana, that's what kept us in it, I believe.
At halftime, the emotion in the locker room, like, we wasn't down, nothing like that. We knew we could come back, but when he caused that fumble, like, I was like, yeah, we're going to win.
Nick takes the snap, play action, looking right to throw. Left hands the ball to the end zone, man open, caught it! Touchdown to Alan Turner!
Alan Turner caught his first pass of this game. It's an 8-yard score with 11 seconds to play in the third quarter. It's tied at Bloomington, 21-all with the Big Ten Hoosiers. Bootlegs right, he's looking to throw, he tosses it. Nope. Big Ten can't hold it, it's incomplete on the boundary. Southern held on 4th and a half. And what a testament to the line play, Joel.
Talk about respect for the guys up front.
Indiana's teetering. Southern's confident. Here's the snap. Handoff. Whitlock. First down and more. 35. Breaks the tackle to the 30. First down to the 29. And down he goes. The Gateway's best rusher. Give it to the league's best rusher.
In motion comes Alan Turner. Nick, straight drop back. Wide open. Touchdown, Southern. Touchdown, SIU. Bill Goforth, 29-yard touchdown.
Tailback, Whitlock to the 5, he's going to get there, it's a touchdown! 9-yard touchdown run for R.P. Whitlock, and the Salukis come right back with a TD of their own. 2-10 after Indiana tied the ball game, the Salukis regain the lead.
It was at the 8-yard line, and Coach called, and I was like, you know, I knew this play was going to be a touchdown because they hadn't been able to stop the play all game, and it was just confidence, man. My old line, you know, I had faith in them guys all year, and I just knew, you know, all I had to do was hit the right seam. You know, and just getting in zone. That was the greatest feeling in the world, you know, go up 35-28. Go inside,
you go. Here's Lewis to throw. Hit as he throws, down he goes! Back in the 39-yard line. Wims with the sack.
I was exhausted. I came on to the sideline. Coach Kill said, you gotta play when you're tired. And I did it, and I went back out there. Play.
On 4th down and 17, ball game for Indiana and Southern. Hit, he's still going down, and he goes down, and they get the sack. And Southern might beat a Big Ten team on that one. Lorenzo Wims with the sack.
It was a grudge match, I would say. So I had a chip on my shoulder that game, pretty much, I could say. I went out there, and you seen what I did.
Time throws it deep up the middle, high, caught near midfield, dropped the ball, incomplete. A good break up there. The receiver hasn't gotten up yet. They leveled a serious blow.
Fred and Jordan took him in half, just took the ball completely out of his grasp with that hit.
Nick Hill has a victory. He and the Salukis beat Indiana 35-28 in Bloomington. Hill heaves the ball, and the Dogs celebrate one of the biggest wins in school history. 35-28 in favor of the Salukis.
That's something that we'll remember for a long, long time, you know, in the crowd waiting for us as we left the field, you know, the locker room after the game.
And I stayed back, I was kind of dancing around, but the feeling that came over me in that game was unbelievable. I mean, words can't describe. That was an awesome feeling, you know, to beat a Big Ten school. Right?
Before the season, our team council and coaches, you know, came up with goals, and that was definitely one of the big ones, is to get a victory over a Big Ten team like Indiana.
To come back from a 14-0 deficit against a Big Ten team and just see everybody come together and not get frustrated and finally get a W was a good feeling to have.
It was a big win for our program, obviously. You know, the first Big Ten win, not only for our school, but for our entire conference. So that meant a lot to us. I think it meant a lot to the seniors. I know, of course, it meant a lot for me, and I think it was huge for everybody.
It was great, you know, just to see them shake our hands and their heads down, like, man, we just lost to a D1AA school. It was great, and seeing the fans leave the stadium early and hear that big SIU chant, it was just a great feeling. I mean, can't get no better than that.
With the win in Indiana, the Dogs proved a force to be reckoned with in the Gateway Conference. The Dogs were flying high after their first win over a Division I opponent since 1983, and they were looking to carry that momentum into Arkansas Pine Bluff.
That game was more like a back home game, backyard type of football game, where everybody go after who they think is the best, or go after that person to try to get them out the game. So that's less they have to worry about. Guy that pulled my jersey, I played ball with him. We didn't play football together, we played basketball. So, you know, for him to rip my jersey, I kind of called him up the next day. It was like, you ripped my jersey. He was like, yeah, I know, I'm trying to get you on the ground. He's like, I can't tackle you, but I'm gonna grab something. So, you know, that was all funny games after game.
Randall, the tailback, who has the ball off right guard and scores his first Saluki touchdown. And the Salukis make it a 13-10 ball game with the Kansas transfer's first SIU score. It's Arkie to the 45. He has running room to the 40. Makes a move to the 35, down to the 31-yard line. Arkie with an 18-yard run. Hills in shotgun. Pine Bluff shows blitz, does. It's still keeping it to the 10. He's to the 5 and scores off left hand. Nick with an 11-yard run.
With a convincing victory over Arkansas Pine Bluff, Southern was 3-0 and ready to kick off the Gateway Conference portion of their schedule, welcoming Indiana State to town.
He's something like Superman. I mean, the kick and flat out jump. So when he throw a lot, Braden, a lot of passes, there's usually passes that if you throw them to anybody else, it's an incomplete pass. You know, it's very overthrown, a bad throw. But Braden, he adjusts to the ball, and he had great hands.
He's got real soft hands, and when he made that one-handed catch at Indiana State, I couldn't believe it.
Pulls it down, he's going to run. He's to the 30, he's to the 25, near sideline 20, might score. Nick is going to score. TD for DuPoint's Nick Hill.
Southern pounded the Sycamores 55-3, but the headliner of the game was Craig Coffin. The four-year starting kicker began the night second all-time in points scored at SIU behind legendary running back Tom Koutsos. But with one swing of the leg, that all changed.
And Tom Koutsos steps aside for Craig Coffin, who's Southern's all-time leading scorer, 24-3 Dogs.
Coffin will go down as the best kicker in SIU history. He split the uprights with precision during his career at SIU with a 79% lifetime field goal percentage. Later on in the season, Coffin also became the Gateway Conference's all-time leading scorer. The Cape Coral, Florida native finished his career with 376 points, shattering the old record by 41 points. He also holds the record for most field goals made by a Saluki with 49.
I call him a clutch kicker. Heavy situations, doesn't matter what it is. He's the one that's more calm than the coaches, I'll say.
And I think, man, he's one of the best kickers I've ever been around, I've ever seen play, and I think he's a little underrated right now.
I appreciate all my teammates and their confidence in me to do that, but sometimes I doubted myself this year, but ended up turning out all right.
Next up for the Salukis was a homecoming matchup with the Western Illinois Leathernecks, and the ninth-ranked Salukis were in for a shootout.
more of a who wants to win, who has the heart, who's going to compete type game.
That they threw out in the flat, he got a great read on the play, and he just came up and just nailed the guy.
I was right next to AJ when he had that hit against Western Illinois, and I kind of wanted to go check the guy just to make sure he was still breathing okay, because it was a pretty powerful hit.
I could have played it. It took an interception to save, but I was like, man, I'd rather take the hit.
With the nail-biting win, SIU improved to 5-0 on the season. Part of the reason for the Dogs' early success was because of their young defense. Anchoring by starting seniors Patrick Jordan, Lorenzo Wims, Micah King, Marlon Heaston, and A.J. Wallace, SIU's defense ranked first in the Gateway in sacks, total defense, and scoring defense. Micah King was first on the team in forced fumbles as well as sacks with 5.5. Redshirt freshman Brandon Jordan led the Salukis in tackles with 96, receiving Freshman of the Year honors in the Gateway Conference. Chauncey Mixon joined Jordan as another rising young talent for the Salukis with 54 tackles and 4.5 sacks. After two tough losses in conference play, the Salukis traveled to Springfield, Missouri to take on Missouri State in a must-win situation.
Oh,
back and beat Missouri State was a big momentum change. That pretty much changed our whole season because after that, we was pretty much ready for anything.
You know, if we had won that, our season was over. Didn't matter what we did. If we had lost that game, we wouldn't, the playoffs wouldn't have happened. Nothing would have happened. We'd just been playing for pride from then on out.
We went in there, we played well, and kind of got our season back on track.
With the win, Southern sent the Bears to their seventh straight loss and climbed to 6-2 on the season. One of the big reasons for the Dogs' early success was the play of their special teams. Southern constantly pressured the punter all season long and had four blocked punts to show for it. Another big part of the special teams was Craig Turner. The junior All-American return man is first all-time at SIU in punt return yards with 852. He's just 229 yards away from breaking the Gateway Conference record. Turner had a career-high 233 return yards against Western Kentucky, including an 83-yard punt return for a touchdown. SIU proceeded to lose a heartbreaker at Youngstown State. Next, the Salukis returned home for a matchup with nemesis Northern Iowa. And with playoff hopes in the balance again, the Dogs were put into another must-win situation. In this game, the Salukis took over in all facets of the game right from the start.
SIU Northern Iowa, it's an elimination game. We say that because the loser is all but eliminated from the 1AA postseason tournament. He has time, throws far sideline, go for it there, caught it, 24 and out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Second down and 8, there's the snap, Hill off play action to throw, setting up, throwing to the 5, caught by Jones, turns it up and scores a touchdown. On the option, they toss to Lewis. He keeps off left end of the 15, cuts it up to the 10. He's to the 5. He heads for the goal line. Did he get in? He did not.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
It's a handoff to Lewis. He takes it off left end and dives into the end zone for a touchdown. In Northern Iowa, there's a Brian Wingert extra point away from tying this game, and this game is about to be tied because Wingert has not missed a point after this year. He is 32 for 32, and in his standout career, he is 145 for 150 on point after attempts. Wingert's kick is blocked, and it's picked up by Trevor Moe. He runs up the far sideline. He got a block from Bruner. Can he make it? Trevor Moe is going to go the distance, I think. One man's chasing. Moe to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. How do you do? It's the first time they've missed an extra point all year, and Trevor Moe picked up the loose ball and scampered up the far sideline, and Southern gets 2 points out of the play. I don't know that I've ever seen that.
After Trevor Moe blocked the extra point in Northern Iowa and ran on the field, I thought he was going to get caught. I didn't know he was that fast. It was good to see him do that, and it just changed the way the game went and changed our season.
I think the play that turned the season around, you know, even though it's mid-season, when it happened, was the block extra point by Trevor.
Play action, Nick to the end zone, Turner's there, touchdown! Touchdown, SIU! Second and 9, Nick off play action to throw. They keep Arkey in the block, they throw, caught by Jones, 2015. He's the 10, breaks the tackle to the 5, rolls to the 3. First and goal. Hill takes it, gives it off to Arkey, who hits to the end zone for a touchdown, and Southern is ahead 22-13. takes it 46-23.
Game against Northern Iowa. You know, the offensive line played great that game. We really came together when we needed to, and the whole team for that matter just stepped it up. You know, it was, we were in the playoffs after we lost to Youngstown, and we knew that, and we came out with a passion to play.
You know, we were just clicking, and everything seemed to work for us that day, and that was probably the best overall team performance that we put together.
SIU finished the day with 47 points, the second most ever for a Saluki team playing against the Panthers. Defensively, the Dogs dominated as well by forcing three interceptions. For the final game of the season, SIU welcomed the Southern Utah Thunderbirds to McAndrew Stadium. But this time, the only thing thunderous was the Saluki onslaught.
Whitlock, he sets the school record for touchdowns in a season. Ark gets off left edge 40, he's to the 35, 30, might score. Breaks a tackle, he is going to score. Ark, he goes for a touchdown of 41 yards. One of the best Salukis to ever play just scored another touchdown.
Thunderbirds 59-0 in an effort to leave as little doubt as possible in the NCAA committee members' minds. A key factor in the win, as was all season long, was R.K. Whitlock. Whitlock finished the game with 170 yards rushing and three touchdowns. He will no doubt go down as one of the best Saluki football players ever. In his senior season, the running back rushed his way to 1,748 yards, and in 35 career games at SIU, he ranked second all-time with over 4,100 yards rushing. In his last five games, he ran for 855 yards and 14 touchdowns. On top of setting the single-season record of 25 rushing touchdowns against Southern Utah, the Rock Hill, South Carolina native also became the school's leader in all-time purpose yards with 5,494, second most in Gateway Conference history.
Arkey deserves everything that he's ever got here, especially the records. I think, you know, he'll never tell you that he deserved to get a record, but I guarantee everybody in Southern Illinois was happy that his name's going to go down in the record book because he deserves to be remembered by the people here.
He never takes a playoff, never takes a day off. He's durable, you know, you can give him the ball 30 times a game, and he never complains. I've never heard the guy complain.
I've played with a lot of good running backs, some guys that play in the NFL now and here, you know, is running back you. But yeah, Arquise, he's got something special that not too many people have. Number 24, he makes the offensive lineman look good. You know, sometimes I'll just be running down the field, you know, I know who I'm supposed to block, but when there's space, we're not that great, and he somehow brings them to you and makes you look good.
Our key was just being our key, it really was, and he did that for us all year long. He carried us all year long, and you know, we knew that he was going to step up, and we just looked to him to carry us, and he did, and that's what great players do.
His 150 points in a season ranks first among all other Salukis. Whitlock, a Coffeyville Community College transfer, rushed for 20 100-yard games and is tied for first in school history with 52 touchdowns scored in his career. He finished third in the Walter Payton Award voting and was named Offensive Player of the Year by the College Sporting News. Whitlock was honored for all of these accomplishments with a spot in the Hula Bowl. The future Saluki Hall of Famer had just three touches in the game, but he also was included in the Division I AA Coaches All-America team as an all-purpose player, as well as first-team All-Gateway and being named to the Walter Camp Football All-America team. Winning the Southern Utah game big helped as the Salukis advanced to their fourth straight playoff appearance, the second longest active streak in Division I AA. Next up for the Salukis in the first round of the playoffs was the Tennessee Martin Skyhawks and one of the greatest games McAndrews Stadium has ever witnessed.
Down 7-0 early. Play action, Hill to throw. Setting up, throwing to the far sideline. Picked off, he threw it away, and they might get a touchdown, and they will get a touchdown. Jack Greenwood picked it off near midfield and took it up the boundary. It's caught at the 41 of Southern. The 40 fumbled the football. There's a scramble. Southern might be on it. And the Salukis, let's see, they are. Martin turned the ball over. Handoff, Whitlock off right end, and did he get to the goal line, and did he get in? He did not get Fumbled. In, and they came away with the ball that they signal a touchdown. They say he crossed the goal line before Martin stripped the ball.
The Tennessee Martin game was one of those games that if you ask anybody that was playing, we had that sense in our mind that, you know, we were going to win that game. I mean, I remember talking to Will Justice on the sideline. We were down by 20 points, and we just looked at each other. We knew we were going to win that game.
Well, UT Martin, I knew we had them. You know, all we had to do was just get ourselves composed and get our feet underneath us and start doing what we do, you know. And once we started getting going, there was nothing that was going to stop us that game.